Hello everyone, this is Master Max Sitted 8 with a retrospective on the entirety of the Reactors Like Cherries The Lost Episode series. I'm gonna go over all the videos I created throughout the ages in this epic series of mine, with the exception of Reactors Like Cherries The Lost Episode 6. I should definitely mention that before starting. I will not be covering that video because I did in the video that was uploaded just before this one. So, if you were here specifically for Reactors Like Cherries The Lost Episode 6, I would invite you to take a look at the video I uploaded before, where I talk in great details about the thought process behind all the sketches in The Lost Episode 6. I believe the video was around 1 hour long, so I definitely had quite a lot to say about The Lost Episode 6. I feel like this is not going to be any different. It's probably going to be over an hour long, so just make yourself comfortable. Just get a snack or, you know, do something on the side like playing a video game or reading a book, whatever relaxes you, because I'm going to be here for quite some time. There's obviously a lot to say about all the videos in the Reactors Like Cherries The Lost Episode series. And I would also like to say that this is an idea I'm borrowing from King Jamin. King Jamin did his own retrospective of Reactors Like Berries, his own wonderful series, and the video was about 2.5 hours, so it was pretty much a movie at this point. I'm hoping mine is not going to be as long, but still, it was a wonderful watch, and I really wanted to stress the fact that this is something that was inspired by King Jamin's video, so definitely go ahead and support him, subscribe to his channel. Whatever chance I have to plug King Jamin's channel, I'm gonna seize it and just tell you to take a look at the video description and subscribe to Jamin's channel. He's been a huge supporter of the Great Legion for several years and a huge part of the Reactors Like Cherries community. I feel like Pytosucker, obviously, he's the dad of the Reactors Like Cherries community, right? He's the main guy, he's the guy who started it all, but I sort of continued it, and so did Jamin, and so did Flying S'more as well. Like, we're just kind of the three guys trying to keep this going right now, so why don't you go ahead and support Flying S'more and Pytosucker as well, while I'm at it. Just go ahead, support these three guys. If I'm not too lazy, I'm gonna link their channels in the video description, because they definitely do deserve the support, right? They're very much the guys that keep this community alive, so they deserve all the love and all the attention. And one more thing, Gaming Rose also had a role to play in me making this video here today, because he made a reaction video where he took a look at every single Reactors Like Cherries The Lost Episodes video. And I believe his reaction video was something like 1.5 hours, so yeah, he uploaded this humongous reaction video and sort of prompted me to explain some of the decisions that were made. A lot of questions came up throughout his reaction video, so I'm really gonna do my best to explain some of it here today. But yeah, there you have it. I feel like the intro is long enough as it is, so we're just gonna get started with the very first Lost Episodes. Which, funny enough, I had this whole thing going at the time that it was made by an unknown creator. I feel like if we take a look at the video description, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. Let's see here. This video wasn't made by me. I found it lying somewhere on the internet and I decided to re-upload it. By the way, I'd like to apologize on behalf of the creator if this video offends anyone. It's been made in less than 1 hour and is sort of an experiment from what I've heard. The whole thing was just incredibly suspicious, right? Like, everything was kind of a dead giveaway that it was made by me. I know I start off saying, this video wasn't made by me, but then the more I talk about it, the more it just seems like, yeah, it was made by me. But surprisingly, at the time, people didn't really think it was made by me. Pytosucker, in his reaction video, said, if the creator ever comes up and reveals himself, I'd love to acknowledge him. So, most people had no idea that it was made by me somehow, even though I did a piss-poor job at hiding the fact that it was me. Even the editing style was very reminiscent of what I was doing at the time. The description was just god-awful, but it was still enough to fool most people. Maybe not everyone, but most people didn't assume instantly that it was made by me. So, yeah, I'm honestly shocked at that. But anyway, let us start here. The Lost Episodes. And, familiar intro song now, isn't it? So throughout the entirety of The Lost Episodes, I've always used this theme song here, which, like I said in my retrospective on Reactors Like Chairs Lost Episode 6, is a song from Donkey Kong Country 2. More precisely, I think it's called the Lost Anthem from Donkey Kong Country 2. And there's actually a lot of Donkey Kong Country music throughout The Lost Episodes. It's something that's going to come back pretty often, so whenever it pops up, I'll try to point it out. I'm just a big fan of the game. Honestly, that's what it's all about. I just love Donkey Kong Country, especially the second game. So, yeah, I even start with myself, you know, as if it wasn't obvious enough that I made the video. It starts off with my face, with a bunch of, like, syrup. It's not real blood, obviously. It's just this weird syrup with red coloring. And their Skittles is cool.
I've got a candy cane in my pants. Would you like to have a taste?
So I really didn't know what I was doing. To explain the intro, I didn't know what the fuck I was doing at the time. I honestly did make this video in like an hour or so. I didn't put all that much effort into it. I just threw a bunch of random things together, and I thought it was kind of funny, and I decided, why not just make my own Reactors Like Cherries out of it? There was nothing that was planned out. It was just a bunch of people I was following, and I decided to just throw some random ideas at them, put some sketches together, and this is what came out of it. And Skittles is Cool is a guy I was following. A guy that is, unfortunately, no longer uploading on YouTube. He's been active for several years now, and that's going to be a recurring thing throughout these videos. A lot of people you're going to see here have been inactive for several years, which is always heartbreaking. It's always incredibly saddening to see that, but that's just how it is. That is life, folks.
Okay.
And Pi, obviously Pi had to be the very first sketch. I mean, there was no doubt in my mind that Pi had to start this thing. He's the, like I said, he's the dad of the Reactors Like Cherries community. He's the guy that started it all, so it just felt natural for him to start the whole thing.
I'm sorry, I'm just browsing through videos. And I find Aris Bowl. Pingers!
The first appearance of Creepy Sparkle here. Who, by the way, Creepy Sparkle did not show up in Reactors Like Cherries the Lost Episode 6. I always wanted her to be associated with Danny the Dude, and that kind of started around the second episode. In this one, she just appears randomly, but after that, she's always connected to Danny the Dude. So with him not showing up in the last Lost Episodes, I decided to just not have her around. But yeah, she's kind of a recurrent running gag in Lost Episodes. I just love that creepy ass design, dude. I absolutely just love that creepy ass face.
I wonder if I should show it to you or not. I'm debating on it.
So
yo.
So again, I'm just featuring someone that I was following at the time, the B-I-G-R-O-B, Big Robin here. I can't really explain the sketches all that much. I wish I could give you more of an explanation, but there's really none to give. All these sketches were just randomly edited, randomly put together without really any kind of ideas or plans, like I said, so it's don't just relax, random
look
chaos, a complete
window.
Mess.
Look at the sun.
One thing I remember about this, though, is the fact that Pytosiker was somehow impressed with the editing. He's like, oh shit, that's pretty good editing. Very flattering. Honestly, very nice of him there. Because, like I said, it was just a complete mess. And I certainly didn't expect any compliments out of this. I was just trying something. Oh, God. This one... This one I do feel bad about.
Yeah, not much I can say. If you guys have any suggestions for me, let me know in the comments below, and then I'll try and get on to them.
Okay, I think he did have some comments on his video. I think True Dash Fan had some comments, and I just made it seem like he had nothing. And in Lost Episodes 2, I'm gonna bring this one back where I make it seem like he's got no subscribers, but he does have subscribers. I'm lying here, okay? I'm making it out to be like he's not getting comments and he's got no subscribers, but he does have them, okay? It's just me being a dick, and I feel really bad about it, but... Hey, kudos to True Dash Fan. He saw it as a joke, he took it very well, he was not offended. And I even say it in the description, this video isn't meant to offend anyone, alright? I'm just making some bad jokes, maybe poking fun at certain people. But never was it meant to offend anyone. So, again, kudos to True Dash Fan. I'm still very grateful that he wasn't offended by any of this.
Hello there, this is Jack T.
Oh, great. Yeah, that one. So again, I was following all of the people you've seen here. I was following Jack T. Herbert, and he uploaded this video. I think he was playing some sort of Wii U game, a Wii U party game, and he was recording it with what seems to be maybe a bunch of roommates or a bunch of friends. And at some point in the video, for some reason, which still I can't comprehend to this day, they start grabbing each other's ass. Like, nothing prompts it, nothing warrants it. They just stand up and then start grabbing each other's butt cheeks. I saw the video and I was just kind of dumbfounded when I saw it. And I said, you know what? I can probably make a sketch out of this. And this is how this one came to be. Yeah, that's... Yep. There's several instances of it. So, like, all the screams that were taken, it's just different points in the video where they grab each other's ass. Just saying that out loud. Fuck. You would think I'm messing with you right now. Like, if you're listening to this, you're probably like, yo, Max is making shit up. Like, there's no way they did that. I'm telling you, in all honesty, I swear to God, they did. They just genuinely grab each other's butt cheeks and just went, yeah! Just had these fucking screams on top of it. Unfortunately, though, I believe those videos have now been taken down. I feel like Jack T. Herbert, in retrospect, saw those videos and decided that maybe he wasn't too fond of them. So, as it stands, they're no longer available on YouTube. Serious shame. A real, real shame. Oh, dear Lord. And there it is. The very first time where Alex does that creepy face. And what a creepy face it is. It's all taken from a video of his that is called Creepy Dance, I think is the name of it. It was some sort of Halloween special where Alex Side was dancing to a Halloween My Little Pony song. And I think that was it. Alex Side Does Creepy Dance. The title was something along those lines. And I love that face so much. I wish it wasn't that blurry, though. I really wish the image quality would have been better. So that way, people would have been able to just, you know, cut it out and then use it in sketches and whatnot, but it's just way too blurry. The quality is not good enough. Sleeping time. And that's how Flying Shark is featured. You know, I'm such a good friend. I am such a great friend. Honestly, I'm truly the best. So, I just have my best friend in this video getting assaulted by Alex Side. I don't think you can use that word anymore on YouTube, so I'll just say he's getting assaulted. And he's in a great deal of pain. And of course, this became a running gag that went beyond the last episodes. It was even featured in the official Reactors Like Cherry series. So this really became a big deal in the Reactors Like Cherries community. But yeah, I am so sorry, Flying Shark. I am so sorry for this. So a lot of people, I think we're confused with this bit. It's like Dark Matter just randomly shows up, putting an egg on his forehead. It was supposed to be a cum shot. I'm not gonna dance around it. I'll cut right to the chase. This was meant to be a cum shot, alright? That's what it was supposed to be. I don't think it came across as such. Everyone just saw it as an egg. Rather unfortunate. It was... That's not what it was meant to be, okay? It was never meant to be an egg. It was supposed to be the result of Alex and Flying Shark just, you know, getting to know each other better. But, yeah, I don't think most people got that joke. Now you do.
Holy crap!
I think it was just edited in such a horrible manner that that's why people didn't get it. I really should have done a better job at connecting the scenes together. But again, all of this was made in, 2014? 2013? Something like that? It was made 8 years ago, so, yeah. I wasn't quite as good when it comes to video editing as I am now, so I truly did the best I could. Oh boy. And then we have Jimmy B. Power, the Jesus Man. I probably should mute this, by the way. Through the Fire and the Flames is definitely copyrighted. I think that was Pi's favorite moment. I remember Pi was really happy with this one here, because it featured him in Swiftwing, and it did get, like, the best reaction out of him. Swiftwing, who, by the way, like, he moves so goddamn fast that you can't really make out who this is. Like, there's no way people would make out that this is Swiftwing just looking at this clip. So thankfully, I did like properly credit the people in this video at the end here. Yeah, made by unknown creator. I still can't believe this worked. I still can't believe it worked. Which really worked in my favor. Because if I just started this with made by Master Max City 8, I don't think Deathborn would have been part of this. Like, there would have been no way for me to feature Deathborn if I made it as created by Master Max City 8. So, yeah, it seriously worked in my favor. So, yeah, this is the original cast. WW Rules, that was the original name of True Dash Fan. A lot of people had a name change throughout the years. Alex Side, same name, thankfully. That didn't change. Poor Flying Shark, I still feel bad. And, you know, it's just something that kept building inside of me. The fact that I was guilty about giving Flying Shark a horrible sketch like that. So, whenever a new Reactors Like Cheers Lost episodes would come out, I would try to give Flying Shark a better sketch. Something that wouldn't be as aggravating. And of course, the first appearance of Deathborn. Something which I did mention in Lost Episode 6. Is that Deathborn wasn't meant to be more than this here. All that I ever intended for Deathborn was for him to be a random clip at the end, a random spooky clip with the more lost episodes quote here. It was not meant to be a character. It was not meant to be the creator of the lost episodes, but at the risk of repeating myself, which is something I do quite a bit, I apologize about that. Deathborn was honestly brought to life by Flying Shark. Flying Shark is the one guy that just wouldn't let go of Deathborn, and as a result of that, we'll see him in the second one, in the third one, in the fourth, in the fifth, in the sixth one. It's all thanks to Flying Shark. So, yeah. He created his own worst nightmare. And something I think I'm going to be doing once I'm done here is I'm going to have a ranking for lost episodes, much like King Jamin did. I'm going to rank my favorite lost episodes, so from my favorite one to my least favorite one. And I already know which one's my least favorite. It's not the first one. For some people that may think the first lost episode is my least favorite, it is not the case at all. It's another one, which you'll find out towards the end. But anyway, that's the end of the first one, so we'll move on to the second lost episodes. Which definitely has a better intro. Right, this one, a lot more effort went into it. I was happily surprised to see that the first lost episodes was a success, so I decided to just put some actual work into the sequel. And let's take a quick look at the description here. This video wasn't made by me, so once again I was claiming I'm not the creator. The original creator had his shell removed due to copyright strikes. He saw that I uploaded the first one and asked me to upload the second installment, so I did. I was really pushing this stupid idea that I'm not the original creator. I think out of it just came Deathborn. So it's a good thing I did. It's a good thing I did. Like I said, it's a good thing I never claimed to be the creator, because it would have killed the whole narrative of Deathborn being the creator of the lost episodes. But yeah, let's just go over the intro real quick.
Last episode. Reactors like cherries. Lost episode.
Reactors like cherries. The lost episodes.
Reactors like cherries. The lost episode.
So, kind of crazy to see all the people that reacted to this, right? So, it was the very first lost episodes, and out of it, a bunch of people decided to make a reaction video. And that wasn't even all of them. There were more of them. There were definitely more of them that made a reaction video to lost episodes, but at the time I started making the lost episodes too, these were the only YouTube channels that had uploaded a reaction video, but there were definitely more than them. Definitely more.
Master Max just told me that there was a thing called Reactors Like Cherries in the Lost Episodes.
Honestly, that was... It was so amazing to see how excited Pytosiker was over this. His reaction to the first Lost Episodes is still one of my favorite reaction video to this day. The genuine excitement and happiness on his face. I think it was in the middle of eating dinner, and he was so excited for this video that he just went right up to his room and started recording his reaction video. So I still can't get over that. It's always a pleasure to take a look at his reaction video to the first lost episodes. And then we got some Fire Emblem music in this one. So I did not use the Donkey Kong Country music like I normally would. I use some Fire Emblem music, which is another recurrent thing, and that one is rather self-explanatory. For anyone that knows me a little bit, anyone that follows me anywhere, you know that I'm literally obsessed with Fire Emblem, so of course, it found its way in the lost episodes. And another dead giveaway that I was the creator here. There's the fake demon himself.
Hey everypony, what's up, it's me, Dane the Dude, and I'm with my brother. And now I'm gonna be.
So there's gonna be a lot more wrestling references in this one, and that was all made for Flying Shark. We saw one there. There's another one here with Scott Steiner. There's yet another one with CM Punk, Triple H. So all of these references were thrown in there for Flying Shark. It was all made with the design of getting a reaction out of him.
Become like the new kid. I imagine,
But I should say that the Big Rub as well. The Big Rub as well is a pretty big wrestling fan, so I mean, he definitely came to mind as well with all those wrestling references.
Slade told me that.
Act like a superstar.
Okay, well, I think, you know, that's all. You know, we're gonna talk around.
And there it is. There it is. Creepy Sparkle, baby. Oh boy. Oh boy. This one was so much worse. This one here was so much worse than the one I did in the first Lost episodes. You had to be a wrestling fan. And, you know, the name of True Dash Fan was WWE Rules 27H. So I just assume you would understand that it was a Scott Steiner promo. Scott Steiner is notorious for being extremely aggressive and rather offensive with his promos. So I felt if I associated that with True Dash Fan, he would understand that it's just Scott Steiner being Scott Steiner and wouldn't be offended by it. And of course, once again, True Dash Fan took it like a champ and had no complaints. So kudos to him once more. There's Scott Steiner. Big Papa Pump. And there it is. There it is. So that was taken from a different YouTube channel. That was not True Dash's YouTube channel. It was someone else's. So not accurate. Not accurate. It's all made up, folks. He did have quite a lot of subscribers.
Hello there. This is Jody Herbert. I am.
Oh my God.
Reacts.
I couldn't resist making this one. I could not resist making this one. So Jack made a video where he announced that he was officially quitting reaction videos, that he was moving on to something else. He just wasn't interested in making those kind of videos anymore. So he had this big old speech of like 10 minutes or so saying that he was quitting reaction videos for good. Just a few weeks later, maybe 2 to 3 weeks. It wasn't even a month. I think this says 1 month later. It was not even a month.
There. This is Jetty Herbert, and this is Jack React.
Oh my God, Jack React is back!
That is what he does. After just a few weeks, hey, this is Jack T. Herbert, welcome to Jack Reacts. And I'm like, you motherfucker, you really gonna do this, huh? You really gonna do this? Because it really seemed like he thought about it for like a long, long time. He didn't make this video out of the blue. This is something that had been on his mind for several months, if not more. And just a couple weeks later, there he is. Hey, this is Jack Reacts. So I'm like, you know what?
And this is Jack Reacts.
Oh my God, Jack Reacts is back.
I gotta bring in CM Punk and Triple H to bury him. That was for Flying Shark. Okay, that was for Flying Shark. It's his favorite CM Punk promo thing. So that was all made for him, and it got an epic reaction out of him, so I got exactly what I wanted from this. I know other people were like, oh shit, you know, he's kind of taking it too far now, this is rather offensive. The last episodes kind of always did push the envelope a little bit, right? It was always the darker series of the bunch, so of course, the jokes were a bit more offensive. And, yeah, it...
You have a vagina! That's a mohawk, you homo!
That's it. So, who is with me here?
And then, of course...
At WrestleMania, I put an end
Dirty Herbert?
I mean, I think it's pretty funny, alright? It's just my childish humor getting the best of me here, but again, it was all made for Flying Shark to get a good laugh out of him.
Draping time.
Oh boy. Oh boy, here we go. The sequel. There it is. And that is definitely copyrighted. I probably should mute that. So now, it's not just Alex Side and Flying Shark. Nah. Alex Side invited a few friends. Got Pi, got Swiftwing. It's gonna be a team effort this time. And they're all gonna take on Flying Shark with the same fucking clip. I didn't have a whole lot of material to work with at the time, right? Flying Shark only had a few videos on his YouTube channel, so that one just really kind of caught my attention. And something I couldn't help but notice is the shitty editing here. Hold up. You're gonna see exactly what I mean. Do you see, like, this line here? That should not have been there. I can't help but notice it. Kind of a major editing glitch. I really shouldn't have overlooked that, but I did. I did, like the idiot I am. Jesus Christ. But yeah. Poor Flying Shark once again getting a horrible sketch. But I swear, I finally made it up to him later on in the series. And there's the first appearance of Ratchetness, which is surprising. You'd think Ratchet would have showed up in the very first Lost episodes, because he was, like, the biggest name out of the bunch. And still to this day, Ratchet is, like, close to 300,000 subscribers. It's rather shocking that it took me so long to feature him. And maybe I'm exaggerating a little bit. He's showing up in the second one, right? He only missed out on the first one, so it could have been worse, but still. I feel like he should have been part of all of them. Ratchet is an amazing guy, honestly. Amazing content creator. And about this sketch, just a lazy sketch. Honestly, this is just a lazy sketch. Like, the most simple thing you can possibly do. You just replace whatever video they're reacting to, you mute the audio, and there you go. Then you have other reactors on there, like the Big Rub, Dark Matter, and then back to Ratchet. But it's the most lazy, simple thing you can possibly do in terms of a sketch for the Lost episodes. So not too proud of that one. It was just me trying to extend the duration of the video. I feel that that's what it was all about. It was probably too short, so I decided why not throw in this lazy sketch. I really should have given something better for Ratchet, but I suppose I just didn't have any other ideas. Right, and that brings us to the last one here.
The problem with this episode stems from the one note character that is the great and powerful Trixie. As a performer, she's...
I don't know if people noticed that, by the way. I had one of my friends jerking off in the background, which... Another thing I didn't expect to say today, but here I am, just casually saying, yeah, you know, I just felt like featuring one of my friends jerking off in the background. I mean, seems like a normal thing to include. But yeah, the main inspiration here was the fact that I was kind of obsessed with Trixie at the time. It was the brony days of the Master Max 888 era. And I decided to throw in a sketch about myself, which I'm really, in retrospect, I shouldn't have. I really, really, really shouldn't have. Whenever I show up in any of the Lost episodes, unless it was really, really important and a really funny idea, I feel like it shouldn't have happened. When it comes to this one, it's kind of a mixed bag. I think it was generally a good idea, but at the same time, could have done without it. It's just really self-indulgent and self-centered to include yourself in your own series. So I could have done without it, but at the same time, if I didn't include myself, people wouldn't have been able to see my friend jerking off on my bed in the background. They wouldn't have been able to see that, and I didn't want to take that away from people. So, maybe it did serve a purpose after all. I love how he fucking... His face twitches. Did you notice that? That is some method acting here, baby. That is some method acting. Look at how his face twitches. Oh my god. And I remember the original video where this clip was taken from. I actually have two of my friends... got two of my friends jerking off on the bed. So it's not just Nick. There's also one of my other friends called Olaf, where he has a go at it as well. Oh boy. I need to breathe. This is bringing back some interesting memories. It was a really fun video to make. I'm glad it's immortalized in the lost episodes. Alright, so I just sort of get triggered at Voice of Reason for criticizing Trixie. And then all the ponies are just proud of myself, I suppose. And then... That was so fucking bad, by the way. Oh, that was horrible. I just reversed the clip. So you have the original clip here. And then what do? Genius that I am. Reverse! Genius editing, ladies and gentlemen. Genius editing right here.
Wow. And this was by an unknown creator.
There it is.
If Max ever reveals who the creator is and the creator steps up, shows what you did, man.
See how it all worked out in my favor? Like I was saying in the intro, this all worked out in my favor because it really allowed me to create this story with Deathborn. It just opened the door to this possibility. The fact that Pida Slicker had this bit in his reaction video, and also another clip with Flying Shark, which is coming right up. Probably after... Yeah, okay, after I credit people. So I am forever thankful that Pida Slicker and Flying Shark gave me this opportunity to make the lost episodes a lot more interesting than they were ever intended to be. There you go, Voice of Reason. I don't know what's up with Voice of Reason these days. I feel like it's another guy that probably stopped uploading. And honorable mentions, that was mostly the highlight, the people that made a reaction video to the lost episodes. I didn't get to feature them because I didn't really have any kind of ideas. And Razor Shark Fins, I didn't have any kind of footage that would have worked in my favor. So that's why they weren't included in the lost episodes. I just didn't have ideas or good enough footage. One of the most epic quotes of Flying Shark here. Alright, if you're still listening to this, I want you to pay extra close attention. I'm gonna boost the volume. One of my absolute favorite quotes of Flying Shark. This deserves to be played at full volume.
Seriously, I like the video, even if I'm being raped. And I want to talk to Deadborn right now. If you made the video, come on, show your face, you so-called demon.
How do you say that with a straight face? How do you say something like that with a straight face? Seriously, I like the video, even if I'm being I really liked it. And Deathborn, if you made the video, how about you show yourself, you so-called demon? Bravo. Just wonderful, wonderful scene from Flying Shark. And boom, there he is, the fake demon. Deathborn. And that was like the very first design of him, right? So you don't see the helmet, you don't see the gauntlets. All that it was this this black hoodie with sort of a Slenderman face. Which is something I kept, by the way. The Slenderman face is beneath the helmet. I always kept that as part of the character's design. So, yeah. Deathborn and Flying Shark, it's on! That was the grand beginning of their epic rivalry. It all started in the second Lost episodes, which... honestly, I'm pretty happy with this one. Like, there's definitely some parts that could have been better edited. A lot of parts that could have been better edited. There's one lazy sketch in there I'm not too proud of. I included myself, which is something that... I really shouldn't have, maybe. But, I don't know. It gets much worse, actually, in later episodes. Especially Lost Episodes 4. And Lost Episodes 4 might just be my least favorite. I can't wait to get to this one. So let's just move on to Lost Episodes 3. Starting off with Deathborn. Yeah, hold up. I'll bring up the volume here.
Even as I reveal myself, you brainless morons still fail to recognize me.
He dare reveal himself. Angry now. He didn't reveal himself. Why didn't you reveal yourself? Reveal yourself.
So, essentially what this is... It's a bunch of people that didn't realize he did reveal himself. It's Deathborn. That's... There you go. That's the character. That's who he is. That's who made the Lost Episodes. And still... So many people were like, oh, he didn't reveal himself. You better reveal yourself in Lost Episodes 3. The only one that got it, I feel like the only one that got it on the spot was Flying Shark. He knew exactly what this was. Other people were just really confused and thought it was someone else. Yeah, so Lost Episodes 3, for all intents and purposes, was meant to be the end. This was always intended to be a trilogy. I never intended to go beyond that, but with how popular it got, with how motivated I was to continue, I decided to just keep it going for a few more episodes, and it ended up being kind of similar to Star Wars, in a way. Like, you had the original trilogy, and then you had the three others, the sequels, which... aren't as bad as the Star Wars sequels here. Let's be honest. I hope it's not. Because goddamn. If anything, it's more like the prequels, right? The original Star Wars movies, and then you have the three prequels. With Phantom Menace being like complete shit. Lost Episodes 4 was just horrible. Lost Episodes 5 was alright. And then Lost Episode 6. Masterpiece. The best of the bunch. Like Revenge of the Sith. So, I feel like the Star Wars analogy works perfectly here. It actually works really well. So, yeah, I'm gonna go with that. It ended up being just like Star Wars, and I didn't make the mistake that Disney made of making three other sequels. I'm not doing that, alright? Definitely not. But, yeah. At the time, when I made this, this was supposed to be the end. Oh boy.
To my new video.
Hello, Gastek.
Reaction, that is, and...
He did have some ridiculously long intros. Not only did I, like, fast forward his intro, but I also cut it. The whole thing was, like, 8 minutes long, if not, like, 10 minutes long. Gastek just kept going and going and going and going.
I wanted to try something smart. I wanted to count down in numbers down to three in French, but unfortunately, I only called off the silence, so I'm sorry for that. But three this
un. Oh, there it is. Three this un. Probably one of the most successful jokes out of the Lost episodes. Something that definitely stuck around after this video was uploaded. I'm not sure where Gaztek learned French, but I'm sure glad this bit exists. Treat this Un will forever live on as a running gag in the Reactors Like Cheers community. And here's something I really, really dislike about the video. I fucking included myself again. And this one was completely pointless. This was completely pointless. I hate this bit so fucking much that whenever I look at a reaction video of Lost Episode 3, I actively skip this part. I actively skip this part every freaking time. When I watch the original video or reaction video to it, I skip this. I hate it with all my heart. I hate it with passion. And trust me, if it was only up to me, I'd be tempted to remove the Lost Episodes 3. I'd be tempted to, like, completely remove it just because of this bit. Because it really doesn't serve any purpose. I hate this bit with such passion. It's awkward. It's poorly edited. It's a shit performance from me. Everything about it is god-awful. I hate this fucking bit. I can't say it enough. So naturally, ain't gonna play this. I'm gonna skip right over it, pretend it doesn't exist, because I hate this so much. And it went on for such a long time. It goes on for, what, at least a minute? So what, a minute 52, all the way to 2:52 almost. So yeah, a whole minute of this awkward, shitty bit, where, once again, I include myself when I really shouldn't have. I suppose I just needed to mature a bit more. Like, I needed to grow a bit wiser to understand that including yourself like that in your own fucking series that is meant to be a tribute to other reaction channels is a dumb move. I guess I didn't understand that at the time. Very silly. Very silly of me, but yeah, I just, ugh. I might make Lost Episodes 3 the worst of the bunch now, just because of that. I'll have to think about it once I'm done with Lost Episodes 4. It's definitely between Lost Episodes 3 and Lost Episodes 4, as the one video I hate the most. We'll see, we'll see. I do like this bit, though. I do like this one, the dancing with our local stars. I do like this one a lot. It's got some Donkey Kong Country music, once again. I just felt like it was such a wonderful addition to Pyda's Hiker's Dance. Look at that, look at him go! Look at them moves, baby! Dancing like a wet noodle, baby! Keep it going, keep it going, that's what I'm talking about! That's what I'm talking about! Honestly, it feels amazing to see that after this shit bit with me flexing my French or whatever it was. King of the Jungle, King of the Jungle. Very simple edit. It's not like this took forever to make. I just used a green screen with a forest and fast-forwarded the Pyro's Hiker's Dance. Not much else to it, and then I just stuck his face to a line. King of the Jungle, which, by the way, I should say, this is a reference to the fact that Pyda's Hiker's zodiac sign is Leo. The more you know, folks, the more you know. That's kind of how this came about. I'm a huge fan of anyone that has the Leo zodiac sign. I just get along with those people extremely well. I feel like most of you probably don't give a shit about zodiac signs. A lot of it is exaggerated, like I don't believe every single thing about it, but generally speaking, there's maybe one or two things that are accurate about it. And one thing that is accurate is the fact that Aries generally get along with Leo. And I certainly do. I mean, we got Pi here. Max Chen is a Leo. She's my girlfriend, so, you know, that's how well it is for me. And I've met some of my greatest friends that were Leo, and I love those people very much. So there he is, by Psycho King of the Jungle, the Leo. Oh, shit, that's copyrighted. I can already, yeah, it's running in the 90s. I'm just going to mute that. So, yeah. Another fairly simple thing, I just felt like when I mentioned running in the 90s, people might not have understood the reference in this video, so I wanted to expand upon that with this sketch here. And I do have this very interesting edit here. Okay, that... That is genuinely funny. That still gets me, alright? And I feel like it got most people who made a reaction video about Lost Episodes 3. You just have these people spazzing out, and all of a sudden you got Jack D. Herbert fapping in the 90s. It's no longer my friends in the background. It's also Jack D. Herbert. There's a lot of people having a good time in the Lost Episodes from the looks of it, eh? Now we got Swiftwing. With his update video.
Yeah, that's it. So, yeah. That's all I got for you guys.
It's just a compilation of Swiftwing going, not the greatest bit, honestly. That one was kind of disappointing. Even Flying Shark made a comment to the effect of, how am I supposed to react to this? It's just a guy going, and he's definitely right. This didn't really give people a whole lot to react to. So this could have been much better. Okay. And here comes, like, possibly one of the greatest bits. I don't know if I would go as far as to say that this is my favorite out of all the Lost episodes, but once I'm done looking at all of them, I'll confirm whether or not it is, but, dear God, the golden reactions this one got out of people.
Did you drink my water?
It's definitely the best bit with Flying Shark and Alex Side, that's for sure. It's definitely the best bit with those two. And I just love that you can hear Flying Shark going, "Not again! Not again!" Which, it fits so well with everything people saw up to this point. I couldn't resist making this.
He's a Hall of Famer. Yeah, right, JR. Well, I've got
some... And of course, a wrestling reference.
It just came in a few moments ago. We understand that he has bruised ribs and, well, with all due respect, he's also suffering from anal bleeding.
One of the darkest moments of WWE, when Michael Cole just randomly starts talking about anal bleeding. You can see the two guys next to him, Booker T and Jim Ross, they're both really confused. That was not part of the script. That was not part of the script. He just decided to go off script and just randomly say, oh, he's suffering from anal bleeding. Like a wrestler was beaten down to a bloody pulp and he had to include this injury. For some reason. What? Like, even... Yeah, you see it right there. Booker T's like, what? And JR just shakes his head. It was not planned. Oh, right. Right. We go back to the bit I made with True Dash Fan in Lost Episodes 2 because Big Rob didn't take too kindly to it. And I felt really, 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 really bad. Big Rob took offense to it more than True Dash ever did. Like, True Dash was perfectly fine with this, but Big Rob, not so much. He really did not appreciate that joke. So yeah, I really felt bad. I really felt bad. I... Obviously, kind of wanted to make up for it. Like, don't be like Scott Steiner. Don't use steroids. It transforms you into a bully. Just be a super dragon. And that, once again, so many bits were made for Flying Shark is what I'm starting to realize here. That was another reference for him. The Big Rub really liked that as well. So I was super happy about that. Big Rub really enjoyed seeing Super Dragon. With a Psycho Driver, baby, let's go! Beating up the Young Bucks. And obviously I'm a big wrestling fan myself, so... It was made to get a reaction out of Flying Shark, but also something I kind of did for myself, because... I love this crazy shit. I've been to many wrestling shows in person, and it's always such a fun experience. So, yeah. I love this bit. I really, really love this bit. You know, instead of picking on True Dash Fan, we have words of wisdom here. Telling everyone to just become a super dragon. You can aspire to become a better person. You can aspire to become a super dragon. So, yeah. Really happy about this one. And that brings it to an end. I think up to that point it was the longest Lost episodes. And it will only be surpassed by Lost Episodes 4 and 6. So Lost Episodes 3 was quite long. It was quite long.
Hello everyone, I am Isa, and next
has to... Yeah, and there's a bit with Isa. Gaming Rose did ask the question of what happened with IsaTube. I don't know. Once again, part of life is sometimes people just go on their separate ways and they just really stop communicating with each other. So I don't know what she's up to. I see her being fairly active on Facebook whenever I log onto Facebook, like twice in a year. I'm barely on there, but when I do log on Facebook, I do see that she's still somewhat active. But when it comes to YouTube or Twitter or anything like that, I think she's completely removed from those platforms. And I didn't talk to her in several years now. So, yeah, I really couldn't say. I do appreciate the fact that she recorded this bit for the video. I wanted to include her in the Lost Episodes. And since I didn't really have any kind of footage, I asked her if she could record this like a special message to everyone. Pretty much thanking them for making a reaction video or watching the Lost Episodes, with the exception of Flying Shark, because, you know, don't provoke a demon. Don't do something stupid like that. And Flying Shark was devastated, by the way. I really didn't think it was gonna affect him like that, but if you take a look at Flying Shark's reaction to Lost Episodes 3, that comment really, really hurt him. He did not appreciate that for a second, and he told me face to face, he's like, yeah, you know, when Isa said that no offense is intended except for me, it really got to me and I kind of felt bad. Well, it made me feel bad too. Like, I didn't think it was going to come across that way, but poor Flying Shark was kind of heartbroken over this. So, again, I did try to make it up to him in other episodes, because you can't bully Flying Shark like that. And I'm very sorry that this little bit did. Again, the Lost Episodes, pushing the envelope, man, pushing the envelope, always using a darker type of humor and taking risks. And sometimes, unfortunately, sadly, offending some people, so... It's an unfortunate risk. Oh, Jesus Christ. I can't believe this clip. That was, oh, dear Lord. Where was that? I feel like that was my stepfather's previous apartment. Because he changed apartments several times. And that was recorded at one of his former apartments with the zebra painting. And you can see, like, all the office equipment around it. I just asked if I could borrow his office to record a video at the time, so yeah, that's where I recorded that one. That certainly takes me back. And there he is, Deathborn.
Well, whoever that guy was, we will find out your true identity, mister. Master Max will do the best he can to find out who you really are underneath that herd.
There's nothing under the hood. That's the whole point of Deathborn. He's a faceless demon. It's in the name. There's nothing. And I'm gonna mute this because the jump scare is pretty loud, so there you go. Just had this spoopy jump scare, which it got a few people did jump out of their chair seeing this jump scare, so mission accomplished. It did what it was supposed to do. Flying Shark was not scared at all, though. It barely fazed him. And he just started mocking Deathborn again. But, there can't be a face reveal with Deathborn. There's nothing to reveal. The whole character is meant to be just faceless. There's nothing. It's a hoodie. It's just... I don't know how else to explain it. Like, these people just didn't understand the character of Deathborn. And I feel like there's just... not interested in knowing about him at this point. They probably just moved on from Deathborn or the Lost Episodes. So, anyway. Everyone listening to this are probably very familiar with him. So, you know what I'm saying. You know what Deathborn's all about. The fake demon. Oh, God. Here we go. Lost Episodes 4. God, this one's gonna be a doozy. So remember how I called this one the Phantom Menace? Yeah? The one prequel of Star Wars with Jar Jar Binks and a lot of horrible decisions that were made. This is it's very similar to that. It's very, very similar to that. A lot of horrible decisions were made. And it's the one I'm least proud of. Well, I don't know if it's that I'm the least proud of it, or it's more so that it's the one that I hate the most because of the decisions I made. Not to say, there were some co-creators with this video, some people that send their own sketches to help me make this video. Nothing against them. If it wasn't of them, this video would have been even more of a disaster. It's all on me. It's really all on me. I should have made better sketches. I should have come up with better ideas. I feel like I just rushed it and came up with a lot of ideas that were really self-centered. Like, the whole intro, it's Deathborn and it's me. And it goes on and on and on and on for 3 minutes. Actually, maybe even more. Okay, well, just about, we'll say 3 minutes. 3 minutes of this video is myself and Deathborn. And that is exactly why I hate The Lost Episodes 4. As I said many times now, if I could change anything, this would be the main thing I would change. I wouldn't include myself as much as I did in the Lost Episodes. I really wouldn't. Unless it was for something that is really funny or really important. And this was not important. I could have done an intro that was more focused on Deathborn, like it always was with Lost Episodes 3 and 2 and 5 and 6. It's how it should have been, but fortunately, I thought different back then, and it just came out that way. Fucking disaster, man. Jesus Christ. Anyway, that takes us to the Big Rub's Asylum with a narration that I did once again, featuring myself. I don't know what was going through my head, really. At least I don't show up in the actual sketch itself. Like, you just have Big Rub introducing some fellow patients of his asylum, because he's also part of it. Like, Dark Matter, Blue Star Brony, I think Pi is in there too. Look at that. Look at that crazy face. Like, the editing is okay. The editing's alright. Nothing exceptional, but you know, it does the job. It's okay. I just hate the fact that, once again, I found a way to include myself, but with narration this time. And then, Austin. Like, whenever a sketch that was made by someone else was featured in Lost Episodes 4, I would always just put their name in a corner. So Austin was helping out with this, and so was Zapstrax, and Pytocycer as well. Zapstrax did such an amazing job with this one! Just in comparison to the shit I made that you've seen now, this was so much better. So much better. The face tracking was done exceptionally well. It featured King Jaman, Alex Spy, beautiful job. If there's one bit that I'm proud of, it's probably this one here. The one with Flying Shark. Flying Shark versus Dean Ambrose.
Nope.
I do like this one quite a bit. Packed with a bunch of wrestling references, but yeah, that bit was okay. It's probably like the one redeeming sketch that I made throughout the Lost Episodes 4. Everything else is kind of a mixed bag. There's Spinosucker's bit, which was really well made too. Fucking Swiftwing as a Swiffer. That was fucking brilliant. That was absolutely brilliant. Even had Doge in there. Like, just seeing this, I'm sure Pi worked a long, long time to make sure the tracking was working fine and all. And there's another bit, which I really hate about Lost Episodes 4. I was narrating this one. Sort of trying to make a creepypasta about Creepy Sparkle. That was the intent. Just the editing was kind of shit, and the rating was shit. Everything about it was garbage. It's another thing that I just like to skip. I skipped the intro, I skipped this bit with Creepy Sparkle. There's a lot of stuff I just skip in Lost Episodes 4. So yeah, I feel like I destroyed the video, in a way. Like, I sabotaged the Lost Episodes 4. So there's some regrets there. Definitely some regrets. And Austin, God bless him, made this thing here, which once again fucking features me, which I really wish it didn't. First appearance of Sir Sonic HD in Lost Episodes. That's one of the few good bits I made in this one. Where Sir Sonic shows you how to play with your pingus. pretty lazy editing, honestly. You just have Sir Sonic saying pingus a couple times, and then this black square with pingus written on it. Pretty lazy. I honestly feel like I was mostly uninspired and lazy throughout Lost Episodes 4. I could have done such a better job with this. And, sorry, I'm just being brutally honest right now. I don't mean to be negative and whatnot, but that's how it is, folks. That's how it is. It really could have been better. Thankfully, Zapstrax comes right up with another brilliant sketch. And I'll keep that one muted, by the way. It's got copyrighted music. So I'm not going to unmute this. It also has savory language in the song used. The N-word is something that comes up several times, so I'm going to keep it muted for very good reasons. So people show up to the Cheetos party. You got a lot of the characters Xabstracts created. Fucking pie with the afro. King Jamin over here with that beautiful expression. The flaming hot Cheetos. Of course, Alex died, but yeah, Pie with the Afro. What's up with that? We need to bring back Pie to Slacker with the Afro. Dr. Cheetos himself, of course, there he is. Another sketch that could have been much better. This really could have been much, much better. I'm pretty happy with how the tracking came out. Even the face transitions are pretty good, but it's just like a loop of the same clip. I just keep looping this. So again, freaking lazy editing. I just make it go a bit faster. So, I don't know what was up with me. I really don't know what was up with me. This should have been much better. So, really, it's Austin, Xabstrax, and Pytosiker that carried the Lost Episodes 4. They really, really carried the video. Austin made this brilliant fight between Flying Shark and the evil Flying Shark. And then we have the Ice Bucket Challenge. It's just, I think that's the last bit I made for this video. Yeah, that's the last bit I made. Where 8 feet, for some reason, just pours a bunch of ice blocks in his pants. That's not how the Ice Bucket Challenge works, but sure, that's... that's how it ended up being for 8 feet. And again, it was kind of lazy. I just have a couple people reacting to it, and then I just have Bruni Monster doing a little bit of headbang, trying to make a follow-up to Jack T. Herbert fapping in the 90s. This time it's watching someone fapping in the 90s. It was mostly because of the sound effects. Like, if you listen, I'm gonna put the sound on for this. If you listen to the sound it's making when 8 feet is trying to dry himself, I'm guessing.
Okay, I did it.
Oh god, now I understand where the sound effects were made. Oh, that's better.
Okay, wow, sorry, Jesus. If you guys fell asleep, that certainly woke you up. But, yeah, it's the sound he was making, trying to dry himself up. The, I thought it just sounded rather strange. And, of course, I made a childish joke up with it. Of course... nowadays, we have an actual video of 8 feet doing that. He's not drying off his shirt or his pants. He's doing the actual thing. Moving on. Jesus Christ. I honestly wish I was making shit up here, but no, it's an actual video on his channel. Don't look it up. Yeah, there's Dark Matter. I really do miss this channel, by the way. Whenever I see Dark Matter, I do miss this channel greatly. Maybe one of the best things I did in Lost Episodes 4 is the credit sequence here. I really love how dynamic it was. Like, generally, I would just use a still image, but this one, I was using clips. I love the fact that it's always a different background. It's visually really fun to see, so probably one of the best ones I did. It's one of the few good things I did for Lost Episodes 4. Swiftwing, of course. And there are the people that carried the video. Thank God for them. Thank God for them. Probably the only reason I'm keeping the Lost Episodes 4 up on my channel. Thanks to their effort. Jesus Christ. Oh, and this was fairly good as well. The ending bit with Deathborn. I'm pretty happy with this one. It certainly had a creepy feel to it. With the Binding of Isaac song. Jesus loves me, can't you see? That was creepy as shit. I can put it on, actually. Jesus loves you. So yeah, that was some creepy shit right there. Deathborn, I really did try to make him a threatening character. I did do my best to make him intimidating. But over time, as more videos got released, Deathborn just kind of became a joke of a character, unfortunately. And that's kind of when I decided to just kill him off and be done with him. The whole threatening aspect of Deathborn was long gone, so it was just bad to... It was better to put him to bed, is what I'm trying to say here, excuse me. And put him to bed for good, is what Flying Shark did with his epic slap. But yeah, there you go, Lost Episodes 4. After seeing it, after going through it, I maintain the fact that this is my least favorite of the bunch. Lost Episodes 4 is definitely at the bottom of my list. I really, really... hate what I did in this one. I can't overstate it. I feel like I should have done a much better job. And the only redeeming thing is maybe one or two sketches I did and all the work Austin, Pytocycler, and Zabstrax did for this. Everything else is just... it's a mess. It's a complete, total mess. So... the ranking is becoming a lot more clear in my mind now. We still have to watch Lost Episodes 5, but I have a pretty good idea what my ranking is going to be. But let's end this with Lost Episodes 5, which probably has my favorite intro out of the bunch. I really like the thematic of this intro. And it does feature a familiar song. Oh yeah, we're going back to the OG. We're going back to the very first song I use in the Lost Episodes. So yeah, I really love the idea of featuring all the various Brony reactors that disappeared. Since the last Lost Episodes, and there's a lot of them, as you can see. Zabstrax was really devastating, because Zabstrax actively took part in making Lost Episodes 4, and now here we are with Lost Episodes 5, and he's completely gone. He's just gone and nowhere to be seen, so that was one of the reactors that hurt the most. Dark Matter, Swiftwing, Gastech, Brony Geeks... who I don't think was really well known. Brony Geeks had some fantastic reaction videos. So it really did make me sad to see him gone. True Dash Fan was one of them too. It's insane. And Jack Tiribert was gone legit, for real. He didn't come back with another Jack React. He was gone. And Jimmy B. Power, Jesus Man. Which I feel like that one was the most devastating for Pytocycler. He even had a whole bit saying goodbye to the Jesus meme. So yeah, I wanted to sort of pay tribute to them and use that as a theme for the intro of Lost Episodes 5. So yeah, definitely one of my favorite intros. I feel like that was a good idea to work with. And, of course, it also did highlight the rivalry between Flying Shark and Deathborn. It brought it back to, the tension and the deep hatred these two individuals have for each other. But yeah, pretty damn good intro, honestly.
With the Mega Man music in my ear, man. Seriously, guys, I want to try a Rage game, so it's gonna be a new Let's Play. I will try to finish Creepypasta Land and this game.
That's another joke that went beyond the lost episodes. I know Flanksmore used this. Pytosiker used this. King Jamin might have used this as well. So Flying Shark the game is really something that caught on, and something that we need to actually create one day. Given the chance, we really, really need to create Flying Shark the game. Seriously, we need to sit down and start planning out something like that. It would be absolutely wonderful. So, I still very much would like to create an actual game about Flying Shark. The closest thing we got to it was S'mores RPG. Pytosiker did go on to make S'mores RPG, which, was pretty much centered around Flying Shark. So, we kind of have something along the lines of a game about Flying Shark. So, if you've never played S'mores RPG, I definitely recommend for you to look it up. It's on Game Jolt. I feel like it's still on there, so just type S'mores RPG and you'll find it.
That's pretty much it for this. Excuse me, this Let's Play.
Also, I love the fact that it's something I've been doing quite a bit. Whenever Flying Shark goes silent and he just stares at the camera for like several seconds or even like a full minute or two or three or four, I tend to use that in my videos. There was one instance where Flying Shark was trying to set up a webcam in one of his live streams, and I found a way to loop it so Flying Shark seems to try and set up his webcam for like over 10 minutes. So I've always loved making those kind of videos and using those scenes of Flying Shark. But yeah, that was the only video he ever made about his own game, because like he said, he's too pissed off. And then of course we have a follow-up in the relationship between Alex Side and Flying Shark. But this time around, we're getting a bit of character development. We're getting a special twist.
Now, I tell you what. I like you, and I want you. Now, we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way. The choice is yours.
Well, I don't think you and I will be doing anything any kind of way.
Okay, I see you choosing the hard way.
Okay, cut. This isn't working. Someone get this guy out.
And I'm gonna skip over that. Danny Martian just moved on to other things. Danny Martian pretty much is done with this kind of stuff. So out of respect, I'll move right over that bit. But yeah, that was that was showing a little bit of a twist between these two. Flying Shark decided to be on top this time. And it doesn't matter what Alex said once, he just had to take it. And I think that's the last bit. Yeah, it's the last bit where Flying Shark and Alex side, you know, get up close and personal like that. I didn't bring this up in Lost Episode 6. Lost Episode 6 was all about Flying Shark fighting Deathborn. That's what it was all about. So, yeah, this was the last time we ever see these two going at it. sad, but it had to end at some point. The joke had to come to an end at some point. It went way longer than it should have in the first place, to be honest with you.
My PlayStation 3.
Right.
Oh, no. Oh,
I think
no.
It's the first time I featured Latix in a lost episode. Latix, for some reason, is craving a PlayStation 3. And something about this that I should have changed is the fact that Flying Shark isn't sad because Latix didn't join him in bed. He's sad because Latix is eating a PlayStation 3. And we actually talked about it after the video was uploaded. He's like, I would be crying because he's eating a PlayStation, not because he's not joining me in bed. And I'm like, you know what? I should have worded this differently. I should have wrote, he's eating my PlayStation 3 or something like that. It shouldn't have been this. So, yeah, I probably would have changed this in retrospect. Here we got Pi. By doing something that we can't see just yet. We can hear it. We can hear it. We can sort of guess what it is. He's licking his chops. Taking a good look at some saucy Flying Shark content. You can see him twitching there. He's twitching. He's twitching. And he's about to explode. It's a fucking stupid joke. Oh, and that one, another wrestling reference. Jesus. I lost count of how many wrestling references I put in those videos. But this one was even more obscure because this guy here, Kenny Omega, my favorite wrestler alive on this planet, he's not from the WWE. And I feel like most people are much more familiar with WWE than any other wrestling promotions. Kenny Omega is someone that wrestled in Japan, and recently, he's been wrestling for AEW, which is an American company that was founded in 2019, and I'm not gonna give you the whole story here, I'm just trying to explain it. He moved recently to that American company, which is pretty much the second company, just behind the WWE. So, yeah, he's a very talented, very awesome Canadian wrestler that I've been following since 2013. And I put him in there because I knew Flying Shark would once again get a pretty good reaction out of this. And also, it was an opportunity to use King Jamin.
Before I call the police on you for breaking and entering, I could get you done for that, mate. You get out of my house. Get out.
And I kind of redid that scene, by the way. If anyone was paying attention in the intro of Lost Episode 6, let me show you very, very quickly. I don't want to take too much time with this, but if you take a look, I featured the exact same scene, but instead of Kenny Omega, I put Flying S'more in his place. I thought it was just more fitting to have S'more there instead and have Jamin just be like, you get the hell out of here, I'm gonna call the police on you. So I took this scene and just, I don't know, gave it like a fresh new coat of paint. I updated the scene, if you will.
I'm watching you.
But yeah, a very, very memeable scene of King Jamin here. This, you can put like any character you want. That's the beauty of this. You can literally have any character you want and have Jamin just have them at gunpoint asking him to get out of his house. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And then we have Deathborn with good humor. That was just me experimenting here. That was me experimenting with this concept of I'm gonna have something extend for way longer than it should, and I'll see how people react to it. That's pretty much what it's all about. And good humor, by the way, is written in the background here. That's why it's called good humor. It's written right behind this guy there. So that's how the name came to be. But yeah, I just wanted to create this really uncomfortable long scene. And just after that, you got Flying Shark.
And a video again on YouTube. It's not fucking right.
With his own memeable scene. Like, if King Jamin, if the best scene is with him with his gun, asking for whoever to get out of his house, Flying Shark's reaction to Cuthwall and Dekimekura for Christmas is very much the one scene that has been used the most. I mean, this works for so many different contexts. And also, what a beautiful freeze frame. Can we please enjoy that for a little bit? That's my thumbnail right there. That's my fucking thumbnail. That's just perfect. Oh my god. Whew. But yeah.
I'll just take a break and I'll come back with the conclusion of all this.
Oh, and you certainly will. You certainly will. Flying Shark will be back.
This is the BIGRB, and I am back, baby.
So, for this one, I didn't really know what to do with Big Rob. I really, really didn't know what to do with Big Rob and Danny the Dude, so I just sort of put them both together with this Bane scene from Batman. You merely adopted the dark. I was molded by it. And it also gave birth to Flying Shark just shouting, Blighten! That joke has been dead for too long, by the way. Whatever happened to Blighten? I haven't heard that in such a long time, but seeing this, it's coming to mind right now.
I didn't see the light until I was already a man. By then, it was nothing to me but Blighten.
Just roll now.
So yeah, that's the best I could come up with for Big Rob and Danny the Dude. It's not the best scene, but it works, I suppose.
It's proceeding as expected.
And then we get some more Fire Emblem music, of course.
I think we need to settle things then. You want to fight me? You want to kill me? You will never be able to do it.
And the end credit sequence was pretty good for that one too. I actually took the same concept and applied it with Reactor's Like Shares Lost Episode 6. To me, like, this was the best possible way to credit the people featured in the video. You just have like full screen with them, the name. And Lost Episodes 5. I don't think I showed up once. I did not show up once in it. And you know why? Because I, like I said many times, I generally felt so bad. I felt like such a rotten scumbag for having featured myself so much in Lost Episodes 4 that I wanted to make up for it 10 times over. So Lost Episodes 5, I do not even show up for a second. Not once do I show up, so kudos to Master Max Citadate of 6 years ago. Then we got that creepy scene with Deathborn, and there's a... Some people saw it, others not so much. You see like a dead shark at the end. It's really faded, so it can be hard to spot it. But yeah, you just have this dead shark, and I'm sorry, I'm hearing Fox the Puss, I think. Let me go back to Flying Shark. I want to get that perfect freeze frame again.
Fucking right.
There it is. There it is, baby. I'll rank the lost episodes with this beautiful freeze frame in 1 second. What is it? Fox? Okay, you come in. What's up? What's up? Ah, boy. You alright? No, oh, Jesus, he's never alright. But yeah, that was pretty much my entire retrospective about all of the lost episodes. It really helps me put things in perspective. Having had the chance to go through all of them once again makes it so much easier to do a proper ranking of all the lost episodes. So, after giving it some thought, after looking at all the videos, I can definitely say Lost Episodes 4 is at the bottom. The very, very bottom. It's the one that hurts the most to watch. Like, I can watch any of the other ones without a problem, but Lost Episodes 4, it's difficult for me. It's honestly pretty difficult. So Lost Episodes 4 is at the very bottom. Then I'm kind of torn between Lost Episodes 3 and Lost Episodes 1. Boy, let me go over Lost Episodes 3 again. I feel it was a pretty good one overall. It's that one bit that I'm really disappointed with. Okay, you know what? I think that's what I'm gonna do. Lost Episodes 4 at the very bottom. Then at number 5, we have Lost Episodes 1. Or, did I say Lost Episodes 1 at the very bottom? I mean Lost Episodes 4. Lost Episodes 4 at the very bottom. And then at 5, we have Lost Episodes 1. And then at the 4th place, we have Lost Episodes 3. And then at the 3rd place, we have Lost Episodes 2. Which really came as a surprise to me. I forgot how good this one was. Lost Episodes 2, pretty solid. And then in 2nd place, Lost Episodes 5. And of course, favorite of the bunch is Lost Episodes 6. And I feel like that's how it is for most people that made a Reactors Like Cherry spinoff, or even Pi with the official Reactors Like Cherry series. I feel like Pi would say that the last Reactors Like Cherries is his favorite. Jamin confirmed that Reactors Like Berries, the last one that came out, Reactors Like Berries 8, is his favorite. And it's not any different for me. Reactors Like Cherries Lost Episode 6 is my absolute favorite. I feel it's the most consistent. I feel the jokes are the funniest, and the editing is the best, so it's my own magnum opus. Lost Episode 6 is pretty much the best I can possibly do. So, yeah, that would be my final ranking. If anyone made it this far, or if anyone's reading the comments and you see my ranking, you can give me your ranking if you feel like doing so. This was a wild ride. Tis was a wild ride, that's for sure. But I feel now I can finally bring some closure to Reactors Like Cherries of Lost Episodes. This is it, folks. This is the end of the end. And I was hoping this was not going to be too long, but I'm looking at it. It's almost 2 hours now, so I'm sorry. This is such a long video. But again, I just kind of wanted to do this to help me move on from Lost Episodes. So, yeah. It's the end. Finally. Now I'm a little bit, I don't know. I'm feeling a lot of emotions. I'm feeling a lot of emotions right now. I feel like I'm going to go ahead and eat some ice cream and cry in the shower or something. And feel some deep regrets about some of the sketches I made. Oh, God. God, some of them were just horrendous. Really painful to look at. And I didn't even... I glanced at them. I can't even say I looked at them. I, like, skipped over them. And that alone was enough to just make me cringe. So, yeah. I need a breather. I need to leave, but this has been long enough already, like I said, so thank you so much for listening to all of this if you did. Thank you for supporting the Lost Episodes, for all those who have. I'm definitely glad I created the Lost Episodes. It's not something I'm ever going to regret. Maybe I'm going to regret making some of the sketches throughout the Lost Episodes, but I will never regret making the series overall. Like, this is something that brought a lot of people together, something that paid tribute to some of my great friends, and I couldn't possibly regret doing something like that. And if the Lost Episodes inspired people to make their own spin-offs, I feel like that is the biggest accomplishment the Lost Episodes did. If it somehow found a way to do that, then mission accomplished. That's really, in a way, what it was all about, to show people that they can make their own version of reactors like cherries. And we've had a lot of them. We've had a lot of spin-offs. Jesus Christ, we sure had a lot of them. Unfortunately, some of the spin-offs have been removed from YouTube, but we still have quite a bit of them. And even something interesting, even some people on my Discord server talked about doing their own spin-offs. How about that? How about that? Some people decided to just take their own shot and put some material together and have their own spin-offs. So to this day, somehow in 2022, December 2022, Reactors Like Cherries lives on. And in many ways, I feel like this will be one of the main things when it comes to Pytocycler's legacy on the internet. It truly will be. It's something that passed on to him, you know, it's something that started with him, I should say, and got passed over to me, and then it passed over to Jamin and Flying S'more and Austin and Zabstrax and many other people. So it's just insane to see how huge this thing got. And it would be very interesting to see Pytocycler at some point making his own retrospective of Reactors Like Cherries, but I feel he's not done yet. I feel Pi is not done with it, so maybe not the time for him to do it. Maybe it's not the time quite yet for Pytocycler to sit down and go over all of the Reactors Like Cherries videos, because I feel like there's, maybe there's not like five more Reactors Like Cherries to come, but there's maybe one or two left for him to make. I could definitely see Pi make at least like one more Reactors Like Cherries and end it at Reactors Like Cherries 8. I could see that. I could see that. So, time will tell. Time will tell. But for now, I will take my leave. I feel like I'm butchering the English language enough as it is, and my throat is killing me. I've been talking nonstop for 2 hours without drinking one sip of water, so my throat is hurting like a bitch. So I'm gonna go ahead, take my leave, and I'm gonna wish all of you wonderful people a nice, wonderful day. Take care of yourselves. Happy holidays. I feel like it's rather a good time to say that. So happy holidays. I wish you a wonderful Christmas time. Create some wonderful memories with your friends and families. And once again, thank you to all the support for the Reactors Like Cherries Lost Episode series. It is now officially over. This is the end of the end. I'm done. Not to say that, I want to make this clear, not to say that I'm not going to make like a random clip sometimes of like Flying Shark doing some crazy shit and it's going to look a little bit like Reactors Like Cherries Lost Episodes. I can do some one-offs where it's not really Lost Episodes, it's just like a clip with Flying Shark or Gaming Rose or Pytocycler or Jamin or S'more. I'm still going to do that. I'm still going to have fun editing some jokes with them. But I'm not going to do a full-on Reactors Like Cherries Lost Episodes. It's just going to be like little clips that I do because I'm bored and I just thought it would be a funny thing to put together. So you could still find those kind of videos on this channel at some point in time. But Lost Episodes is over. So that is it for me. I was going to say take it away, but that's not really what I do here. So I'm just going to say goodbye. And Fox is a stupid ass bitch. You hear that, Fox? You stupid ass bitch.